Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we're doing part two of my makeup collection video. Last week I talked to you guys about my eyeshadow palette collections. Today I'm gonna talk to you guys about my shadow singles, cream eyeshadows, and shadow sticks. Now I don't have a lot, but I intend to swatch them for you guys, so bear with me. Okay, let's start off. This is the Kiko Makeup Milano number 219, and this is a wet and dry shadow formula, very much like the NARS Dual Intensity eyeshadows. And when you swatch it, it looks like that. It's a very beautiful peachy rose gold shade that is just gorgeous and looks even more beautiful when it's applied wet, because then it has a lot more metallic look to it. The next one is a dual intensity eyeshadow from NARS, and this is Himalaya, which is more of a champagne shade. I'm gonna go ahead and swatch that for you guys, and that's what that looks like on the fingers, and that's what it looks like swatch on the back of the hand. It sort of looks like it's got a taupey undertone. Okay, I have another one from Dual Intensity Collection. It is called Phoebe, and this is more of a lilac purple shade. Again, dual intensity, meaning that you can apply them wet or dry, and swatch, that's what that looks like. Obviously, when you apply it dry, this is going to look even more intense. The swatches that I'm giving you do not have any base on it. They are single swipes, dry. Okay. The next thing I have are two of the Kat Von D shade shifters. This one is called Love Letter, which is more of a purple that has sort of a taupey duochrome. So when you shift it, it looks a little bit different. These eyeshadows are perfect for when you just want to use one eyeshadow, but you want to have dimension on your eyes, perfect. So that's what that looks like. And this is On the Road, which is a green that shifts color to sort of a brown. Why are you not focusing? Sort of a brown, depending on the angle. It also has sort of a purple undertone or duochrome to it. I'm gonna go ahead and swatch that for you guys. This is feeling a little dry now because I have had it for maybe more than 3 years. So this is Love Letter. It's a gorgeous purple color. And this is On the Road. And look at the shift. I mean, seriously, beautiful. I don't believe these are available anymore in the Kat Von D collection because it has been a while. However, if you are looking for that shade right there, I think Makeup Geek Houdini and MAC Club is sort of similar. But if you want an exact one, I have here the Urban Decay eyeshadow. This is a single shadow. This is called Lounge. And I'm gonna go ahead and swatch that for you guys right next to On the Road, so you can see just how similar they are. This is On the Road, this is Lounge. I mean, seriously. So if you like that shade and you can't find it anywhere, Urban Decay Single Shadow in Lounge is the answer. Okay. I also have another Urban Decay shadow here, but they are a duo. I don't remember where I got them from, but it's one of the Sephora favorites. And this is one that's got Half Baked, which is the lighter shade, and Twice Baked, which is the darker shade. And I'm gonna go ahead and swatch that for you. I know that Half Baked is in the Naked Original. I don't know where Twice Baked is, or if it's just a single shadow. That's Half Baked here. It's a beautiful light gold shade. And that is Twice Baked there, which is more of a brownie bronze shade. Beauteous, beautiful. Okay, let me just go ahead and remove these swatches so I can prepare for the next ones. There you go. What a mess. Okay, now we're gonna proceed to my cream shadows. The first one is the MAC Pro Longwear Paint Pot in Rubiness that looks gorgeous. It looks gorgeous on in the pot, but I have to say that when you apply it, it doesn't really show up on me. It just sort of shows like a glisten on my skin. Yeah, and this isn't even. Yeah, that's what that looks like when somebody told me in one of my videos, because I was ranting about this, that it doesn't come off on my skin or show up on my skin. She said, why don't you use it as a highlighter? And I was like, why don't I? So probably gonna try that one of these days. Another cream shadows. I actually don't know how to use this, you guys. And I'm very tempted to give it away because they crease like. Okay, these are the Illamasqua liquid metals. Of course, you can't see the color because they have the lid on. So these are the two. This one is called Enrapture. This one right here is called Enrapture, and this one is called Surge. So this is more like a metal silver, and this is more of a copper. So I'm gonna go ahead and swatch. These swatch beautifully, I have to tell you. They swatch beautifully, but they are so creamy that, so there you go. That's Enrapture and that's Surge. They're so creamy that the moment you put them on your lids, they are going to crease like heck. And if you're going to put them on top of an eyeshadow, they're going to ruin the eyeshadow that you have used as a base. So I honestly don't know how I'm gonna end up using them. I like them a lot. I mean, what's not to like with that, right? It's very beautiful, but it's probably something that I would use if I wanted to do an editorial look or something that I'm just going to show you and then I'm going to remove some if I'm not going to wear it the whole day, because there's no way I can wear that the whole day without it creasing or disappearing on my lids. That's the only drawback. Now we're going to go to my shadow sticks. There's two in here that I haven't actually opened. This two. Oh, sorry, only one. This one is still sealed. This is the Makeup Forever Aqua Shadow in 20E, which is more of a taupe, a metallic taupe. I haven't opened that. Don't plan on opening it just yet because I still have quite a few here that I have to get through. The other one is the Aqua Shadow in 30E, which is more of a rosy champagne shade, and I'm going to go ahead and swatch that for you guys. That's 20E, is it? 30E, 30E. That's that shade right there. They kind of dry quite quickly. This one is 28E, which is definitely a champagne shade, more on the yellower side. Well, I wouldn't say yellow. This is champagne. This is more of a rosy champagne, or a pink champagne is what I would say. There's not much difference between the two, as you can see when you swatch them. So you don't need both of them. Another one, in which is what I used to smudge under my lash line, is the Makeup Forever number 2E, which is a matte brown shadow. And that's the one right there. They can get pretty waxy. You're just gonna have to sharpen them to make sure that they don't disappear. I have two of the Tarte Smolder Eyes, the chunky ones. This one is called Taupe. Not very creative. Okay, that's the one there. That's Taupe. It's beautiful on its own. And you can even use it as a single shadow. You just blend it with a synthetic brush and it's going to give you a beautiful overall shade. The other one is called Rose Gold, which I don't really think is a rose gold. And it's that shade right there. So it's not as rosy. I would say it's more of a bronzy shade. Or yeah, more of a bronzy shade. And that's the one. These are very creamy. I have had these longer than I have had the Makeup Forever ones, but these are much, much creamier than this one. So I actually prefer using these. And then the last shadow stick that I have is from Kiko, and this is their long-lasting shadow stick in 37, which is the color burgundy. And I'm going to swatch that right there. This is also very, very creamy. Same consistency as the Tarte ones. you need to make sure that it clicks when you close it so that you're pretty much sure that it's not going to dry out as quickly. But those are my shadow sticks that I normally use as a base for other colors of eyeshadow. But yeah, that's it. Those are all of my single shadows and my cream shadows and my shadow sticks. If you have any of those shadows, let me know if you use it differently, because I normally just use it as a base or as like a liner on the lower lash line. Let me know how you use yours. Oh, fudge! I almost forgot. I have actually two more cream shadows, and these are the ColourPop eyeshadows from the Kathleen Lights collection. Let me just go ahead and open this. One is called Porter and the other one is called Telepathy. So this one is Porter and swatched. Oh, this one's so beautiful. And this one is Telepathy, which is more of a chartreuse gold shade. Holy cow. Look at that. So those, now I'm done. Those are my single shadows. Let me know how you use yours, if you use them by itself, if you use them as a base, if you use them as an eyeliner. I need all the ideas that I can get from you guys. And yeah, comment down below whatever you want to comment. Subscribe if you haven't already. And then like this video if you liked it, and share it with your friends.